Hello everyone, I'm Justin, and for today's video, we're using slaves. You know, some animes tend to have a deeper meaning behind the story. Sometimes, a curtain is blue for a reason. The author had seriously calculated where the story is going and has been two steps ahead the whole time. And other times, they are just degenerates that want to see a dumb plot become a reality. Yep, today we're taking a look at an anime that came out in the spring 2018 season, and unsurprisingly, it came with a few of controversies. Why is there an ugly bastard in my anime? Why is a kid roped into the story? And why does she like it? Aside from that, there are a few other things that made the anime stand out. But mainly, it was because of its edgy premise and awful writing. And I would like to believe that I know the difference between a good and a bad anime. I mean, I have seen Gibiare, so I know how bad an anime can be. But before we take a deep dive into the story, let me give you a spoiler warning, as I will be talking about the major spoilers in the story as well as its ending. So please take that in consideration. And with that said, let's move on with the video. So, in simple terms, the story is a psychological thriller set in Tokyo, where a group of people is playing a game in which they wear a retainer and compete against each other in a type of contest. The loser becomes the slave of the winner. Simple as that. And you know what rhymes with slave? Well, obviously Yep, we're having this type of show. But you know, it is weird because if this was a hentai, you know the only focus of the story would be about that. But weirdly enough, this is not a hentai but a seinen, which means only edgy stuff, and people have no interest in sex. Except maybe this girl. I swear, I don't know what she's thinking here. So basically, this girl feels her life is kind of boring, and a guy invites her to join her in a game of Dorei Ku, basically just doing it for the thrill, which is already weird enough. But then, episode 2 hits you, and you know for sure you are in a dumpster fire. Now, let me quickly run you through what happens in the whole second episode. So first, a guy in a host club gets tricked by one of his clients to lose in a game and becomes her slave. She obviously uses him for sexual favors. But this guy is also dating and living with a girl, and his master now orders him to dump her so they can be together. But then they are challenged to a game by the main protagonist and lose. So the guy is free now. Great, he can go back to his girlfriend. But, plot twist, the girl becomes a slave to some random kid, and for some reason the kid made her wear bondage clothes, and now he is the slave of her and the kid. And I'm here like, what? What is this? I'm like, how long did it took for the girl to forget the love of her life and become the slave of some random kid? Come on, it was like 2 days at most. Unfortunately, the master writing doesn't stop there. As the story progresses, we learn a lot of things, such as the devices being made by a group of scientists, which, okay, I guess it could happen. And then, a dead woman possesses a slave guy because of reasons. Guys, is this a sci-fi or paranormal? Please pick a lane. And finally, the biggest plot twist. The scientist with the power to automatically slave people with his master device. Because they really needed a way to keep the story entertaining, I guess? Honestly, the only good thing about the show was the dog. And yes, I shit you not, a dog gets into the game and wins a battle just by biting on some guy's balls. And now he's the slave to the dog. Honestly, a lot of the plot made no sense. But I will tell you what. Sometimes you just need to enjoy the dumpster fire. You don't really need a 10 out of 10 every time. And this is proof of that. It was dumb, it was edgy, and made no sense. But honestly, it piqued my interest, And yeah, it won't win an award on script writing, but it will give you a bit of entertainment if you're just looking for some shut off your brain and have fun. Yes, it is basically a dead game anime, but instead of death, the girls are doomed to be the slaves of ugly bastards. And yeah, this story is edginess to the 11, but if you're just looking for this type of dumb story that wraps up kind of nicely in 12 episodes with the story fully finished, then this is for you. And if for some weird reason you want more, then you will be happy to know that just after the release of the anime, two new spin-off mangas released and are fully finished, of course, in case you just want more dumpster fire. If you're looking for something edgy with a bit of spice and a nonsensical plot, then give Dorei Ku a try. It may not be the best anime, but it is certainly funny. And with that said, we come to the conclusion of this anime review. What do you guys thought of Dorei Ku? Let me know in the comments below. Until then, see you guys next time.